Hey everyone, it's Spencer Ross, and coming back at you live for the second time. And actually today I'm in a beautiful new location instead of my apartment. I am actually in Monaco. And I got here on Monday and just been kind of checking out the town, but I wanted to share all with you the views as well as a few cool facts about Monaco. And again, one thing I did mention last time on my first video was one thing that I've really enjoyed about Madrid and moving to Europe was how easy it is to travel, how many beautiful places are to see. So I'm gonna go ahead and give you a view quick, and then I'll go back to me. And we're actually near the palace today, and I have a good friend of mine with me today, Monica, and she was a student at the Spanish school that I was a part of. But as you can see here quick, beautiful view. Again, this is coming from Monaco. And again, here's Monica. Monica, say hi to everyone.
Hola, buenos dias.
And again, like I mentioned, we are right by the palace. So I wanted to give you guys a few cool facts about Monaco. And so, Monica, can you help me out here? You said that there is a prince here, correct?
There's a prince. There's no kings because this is a principality. So there is a prince and a princess. It's Prince Albert and Princess Charlene. And they actually live right behind you guys in that palace. And as I was saying to Spencer, whenever they are home, there is the flag that is up. So today we're going to walk forward. And
you'll notice here once we get past this tree that there will be a flag. So the prince is home.
Maybe we might get invited if he comes out. We never know.
Unfortunately, we can't just go knocking on the door and try to get in. But tell me a little more about Monaco. Is there anything that you like about Monaco? Because you do live here, correct?
I do live here, and I've been living here for the past 3 years. So I really love the cultures. I love how people are so international. And that everyone is like from every place. Everyone is just like from, I don't know, like myself, I'm from Germany, Poland, South Africa, and you find people that are from Spain, from France, from Italy, and it's so cool just to see everybody get together. And Monaco, it's really just like the city to be if you want to get like an international culture.
Perfect.
This is it.
And so as you had mentioned up here, there's no wind blowing right now, but the flag is up.
We did promise
the flag is up.
If you can't see it, the flag is there. So, like I mentioned, the prince is home. But yeah, I've been here for a couple days already. It's a beautiful area, a lot of water. There's a beach area. There's a university here. They have a soccer team. What's another cool fact about Monaco? Do you have any other cool facts you can share?
Another cool fact that I did not know about Monaco is that the first language is French. I always thought it was just English. Everybody speaks English. But actually, if you go do some legal stuff, fill out documents, it's all in French. So unfortunately, if you don't have the basics of French, it will be a little bit difficult.
Oui, oui. Merci. I've been working on my French while I've been here. It's not going very well. I've noticed the pronunciation of French is extremely difficult. So I have really enjoyed learning Spanish, but French will be another day to come, I'll tell you that much. But like I had mentioned, I just wanted to come back at you guys live again here today just for a few minutes, share my travels some more. And as I had mentioned before, if you guys have any questions for me, reach out again. I'd love to share you some tips about traveling, tips about how to get in contact with TT Madrid if you have any questions. But I just want to keep coming back at you guys each week to give you what it's like after the first month of TT, so you can get a little more idea of actual life in Europe. And this is part of it, traveling. That's again one of the favorite parts about it. So
the flag is actually up now. The flag is live, you guys.
We told you it's there.
I promised it was actually there. So once again, thank you guys so much for tuning in today. Monica, thank you so much for your time and
sure.
For your help.
Ciao.
It's always nice to have a native here to show you around. But again, if you guys have any questions for me, hey Arena, hey CJ. Oh, the temperature right now. What is the temp right now? It's kind of,
the sun is right there. Do you want to show them?
Sun's out.
It's probably around like 12 degrees, I think.
Yeah.
But look,
12.
I have my little cup here and I have my vest.
And when I say 12, what is that in degrees? That's what, 24? It's been about 50 degrees outside, so.
You hear those bells?
Hear the bells? It's coming from the palace.
That was a perfect timing.
It was. Brozy, how easy is it to travel from Madrid? It was really easy. So I flew into Nice, France, and Monaco here actually picked me up from Nice, and it was only about 40-minute drive from Nice. So again, I took Ryanair. I got a round trip from Madrid to Nice and back, obviously, for around $75, 75 euros. Again, that's what I was saying. Travel here is very inexpensive. It's very affordable. So again, I hope that inspires a lot of people to travel as well. But Monica, CJ says hi.
Hi, CJ. Hello, how are you?
She was saying how she misses you, CJ. But again, this was just again the palace. A little give you a view in the beginning of a little bit of the coast, the bay, and I'll give you one last look here.
Show the port, maybe.
Oh yeah, let's show the port. Yeah, we'll walk over to the port, the other side.
Because how it works is that the prince and the princess, they actually live on this rock. It's called the Rocher. And now we're gonna just go on the other side of the rock where you'll see the port, where all the yachts are. And the casino is on that side as well. You know, the Monte Carlo casino that you always see in like James Bond movies. It's right over there. So we'll show you guys.
Yes, it's another big important thing here in Monaco. I'm not sure if everyone knows, but this is where the Grand Prix is held, the Formula One race. Mm-hmm. And I was lucky enough last night, I saw the actual starting line of the Formula One race, which is, when is that event held? Isn't it May?
It's May as well, yep. Yeah.
So the Formula One race is every year in May, and it's through the streets of Monaco. So they block off all the streets, they have the cars running, and people are sitting in their rooftops, they're in their apartment buildings watching, literally watching the streets as these cars are racing in the town. It's absolutely beautiful. So again, here's one look from the other side now, how you'll see how beautiful and majestic Monaco really is. You got the clouds and the mountains over there.
So the casino is probably like around, let me see if I can point it there. That green little tower, you see that? That's the casino, exactly. That's where they all go to gamble, have some fun with drinks.
Oh,
Carmen's jealous. Say hi to Carmen.
And then back at the palace again here, and the flag, there it is again. So there's that last look at beautiful Monaco.
Yeah, that was the starting line right over there that you saw yesterday for the Formula One.
Right around that end.
So they actually go here, and the trophies are also given.
Yeah,
right there,
actually, this
port.
Right here, this road, some of the actual road they use for the race, and they go up over here, they grind up right through here, they ride up this hill, come back around, and then there's just this whole loop. It's really cool. So I just wanted to give you guys all a taste again what it's been like here in the last 6 months or so after my TT course. Again, if you have questions, feel free to reach out to me, shoot me an email, a message on Facebook. Absolutely like this page as well when you're done, like this post. Go back to TT if you have any questions. The staff there is wonderful and they're more than welcome to help. But I'm going to sign off here, guys. Thank you so much again, everyone that signed in, that chimed in with questions, the likes, the comments. Once again, thank you to beautiful Monica here
for her
help and some cool facts about Monica. But everyone, have a great rest of your day, and we'll talk to you next week.
Thank you.